Hello everyone. Am I audible now? Okay, guys, thank you for your patience. I'm just going to start now. Okay. So first of all, I was asking about the AI, machine learning, and deep learning. So I'm just going to tell you about what is the artificial intelligence. Okay. So basically, you know, artificial intelligence is the way in which we are making a machine just like the human being. We are trying to make a machine as intelligent as human being, right? So here you can see the image. In this, you can see we have three sections. First is artificial intelligence, and then you can say machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence, and then deep learning is a subset of machine learning. So basically, deep learning and machine learning is a part of artificial intelligence. Okay. ML provides systems ability to learn from the data and experience, right, Aarti? Yes, this is the correct definition. So basically, I was telling ML and deep learning. So in the deep learning, it is a subset of machine learning, and deep learning uses the neural network to simulate human-like decision making. Basically, in the deep learning, we uses the neural networks. Okay. Now come to the next thing. Like nowadays, you are hearing everybody is talking about the artificial intelligence. They want to implement artificial intelligence. But if you think about its history, AI is a very old field. You can see it was first coined in 1956, but nowadays it is getting more and more attention. Why? Because we have two things. First thing is we have good processing power nowadays. We have good machines. We have CPUs, GPUs, and TPUs so that we can process huge amount of data within the few seconds, right? Our second thing about the data, we have lots of data available nowadays. So this is the best thing. Like we have best resources like machines and data to implement the AI, right? That's why nowadays AI is getting more attention, and even every company wants to implement the AI. And this is the example I have taken, from where the AI get the more attention. It was a first time Google held a competition. Google developed a program called AlphaGo. AlphaGo is a combination of neural network and algorithms. This program built by the Google, and they held a competition between the Go game champion and AlphaGo program. First time a program and a person was in a competition, and the AlphaGo program won by 4-1. So after that, Google started to work over the neural networks, and they started to implement different algorithms in the field of AI. And after 1 year later, they again do the same competition, and this time the results was amazing, and the AlphaGo won by 3-0. So basically, Google has announced that the research team behind the AlphaGo would now focus their energy into tackling more complex issues and develop highly advanced algorithms to tackle some of the most complex problems in the world. Okay, so basically, even Google have started to work in the AI more deeply from the 2017 onwards. Okay. And these are the things I already told you. We have big data, we have good processing power, right? We have large storage. So we can implement easily AI. Now come to the definition of AI. What is the artificial intelligence? Artificial intelligence is a technique which enables machines to mimic human behavior. It is just simply, I can say in the simple language, we are making a machine just like the human being. We are trying to make a machine just like the human being. As we already know, human is the best creature on the earth. We have brain, we can think, but the machine cannot think. Machine don't have brain. So we are trying to make machine intelligent as we are, right? For that, what we need to do, we need to implement the ML, okay? So here I have taken a simple example, like either just compare the human and machine, like we have an expert doctor and we have a blank machine. So now I just want to make a, just want to make the machine just like the expert doctor. Then how can I make that? I can use, like, aap logo ko jab koi problem hoti hai, then you will go to the doctor and you will tell the doctor symptoms and doctor will prescribe some medicines and some test that is needed, right? How he knows what prescription need to provide it to you? Basically, he or she have some experience, some knowledge, and the previous experience, according to that, they can prescribe you medicines, right? Same thing we want from the machine, then what we need to do? We need to provide the data to the machine in the form of symptoms and disease. Like I'm providing the data of diabetes, so I need to provide the symptoms and then the name of the disease should be diabetes. Similarly, I just want to give the diabetes data for the 100 or 1000 patients. Then only the machine can learn. Agar mujhe ek patient ke liye learn karana machine ko, ek particular disease ke liye, to mujhe us disease ke bahut sare patients ka data dena hoga. Right? Similarly, agar mujhe more disease ke liye train karana hai, to mujhe jitne possible data ek particular disease ka mere paas available hai, usko उससे मुझे उसको ट्रेन कराना है. बेसिकली वी शुड हैव मिलियंस ऑफ पेशेंट रिकॉर्ड्स टू लर्न फ्रॉम. सो वी शुड प्रोवाइड द इनपुट डेटा टू द मशीन, देन ओनली कैन मशीन लर्न द थिंग्स. ओके, एंड आफ्टर दैट इफ यू गो टू द मशीन, मशीन विल आस्क यू सम सिम्टम्स एंड देन इट विल गिव सम यू प्रिडिक्शन ऑफ डिजीज और सम प्रिस्क्रिप्शन. राइट, यू गॉट इट? And basically, what we need, why we need the artificial intelligence, we have two things, like a human being have a limited computational power and human have a limited working capacity. Like you can work 12 hours, 16 hours, but if you are trying to work beyond that hours, then your efficiency will be affected. Similarly, you have limited computational power. You can compute, like if I'll give a calculation, 14 digits to multiply with the 50 digits, then it will take too much time for you. But if you perform that with the help of machine, then it is, you can do it in very short time. So basically machine have benefit, it have high computational power and it can work 24/7 with the same efficiency. So this is the simple definition. You can read from my screen. Right? Machine learning is a branch of artificial intelligence. It concepts the construction and study of the system that can learn from the data. Right? Basically, we are training a machine with the help of some data. Here I have also taken an analogy there, like I just want to show you, if you are doing some activities, you are doing most of the activity in which you use the machine learning. Basically, you can relate the machine learning with our human learning. What we will do, we are learning from our environment, we are learning from our parents, friends, and wherever you go, you will learn something. But you have mind, you can capture the things very easily. You do not need to repeat again and again. You can learn very quickly. But same thing, if you want to do with the machine, then you need to feed certain data sets. Like I want to go to the, I want to purchase a mango. I will go to some supermarket and then I'll buy some mangoes. I'll choose some mangoes according to the, my experience, like green one is more juicy, yellow one is more sweet. Something, some certain things I already know. So I use my experience and I'll pick which mangoes I need to buy. Similar thing, I want from a machine, then I need to feed the data with the symptoms and then the particular outcome of that symptom. Okay. Here, I just want to tell you the difference between the traditional programming and machine learning. Guys, today I'm just telling you the concepts of the machine learning. This is very important for you guys. Like when we will implement the machine learning algorithm, it is very mandatory for you. आपको ये सब चीजें आनी चाहिए. That's why I'm taking, sometimes you feel it is a theoretical lecture. It is not only the theoretical lecture, it is a necessary knowledge you should know about the machine learning. Right? So basically, what is the difference between traditional programming and machine learning? In the traditional programming, we have some data, like if I'll give a program to write, find a value of a factorial, then what you will do, you will have a computer, you write some program, and then you will feed some data, you got some output after that, right? Similarly, in the machine learning, what we will do, we have some data, we have some output. We will feed to the machine, we develop an algorithm that is called a program, or we can say algorithm, or we can say predictor. Basically, we do initial, in the initial stage, we don't have program. We will be building a program, we have data and we have output. Right? And this is the traditional definition of machine learning. I can skip it. And you can say simply, a machine learning is about predicting the future based on the past. This is very short and sweet definition. Like in the machine learning, what we are doing, we are predicting the future based on the past. How we are doing this? Basically, in the process of machine learning, what you need? First thing, you need some data set. Aapke paas ek data set hona chahiye. डेटा सेट में आप क्या करोगे? बेसिकली उस डेटा सेट को, लाइक मैंने आपको 500 रिकॉर्ड्स दिए, तो आपको क्या करना है उस, लाइक मैंने आपको 100 रिकॉर्ड्स का डेटा सेट दिया जिसमें कुछ फीचर्स हैं और कुछ डिजीज की हम बात करते हैं, लाइक सिम्टम्स हैं डिजीज के एंड देन द नेम है डिजीज का. ओके, यू हैव सम सिम्टम्स, यू हैव डिजीज नेम एंड सिमिलरली यू हैव 100 रिकॉर्ड्स. Okay, so I'm repeating, like 50 records for the diabetes, 20 records for the blood pressure, 30 records for the other pain type of. There is different disease data. You have like 5 disease data and some have 15 records, some have 20, some have 30, some have 40. Okay, so kind of you divided the 100 data into the 5 disease. Now, what you need to do, you need to jumble the data and then you need to divide that data in 2 parts. First part is training data and second part is testing data. How we will divide? Simply, sometimes we take 70/30 ratio, sometimes we take 80/20 ratio. Simply, we divide the data in 2 parts, the 70% or the 80% data we keeping for the training purpose. And the remaining 25% or 30% data we are keeping for the testing purpose. Here guys, what is the training and what is the testing? Basically, training means we are using that data to tell the machine, like this should, if it have this symptom, then X disease, there would be X disease, right? If we have these 5 symptoms, then there would be Y disease, kind of things we have. So first we need to tell the machine. Isko aap log relate kar sakte ho apne day to day life. Like we have small kids in the house And then what we will do, they ask the questions anytime. What is this? What is this? What is this? What we will do, we tell them this is a table, this is a laptop, this is charger, mouse, chair, like we tell them the things. After the certain time, hum log kya karte hain? Hum log unse poochte hain, what is this? Then he or she will tell you this is a table or this is a laptop. How they know? Initially, they learn from us. So we provided them the feature and the label. Both things we have provided them. Okay. Similar thing we need to provide to the machine in the form of training data. Aapko machine ko train karana hai, right? With the help of data and output outcome. You will train the data, you will train the algorithm with the help of training data, and then you will build a model, or you can say a predictor. Sometimes we call it model, sometimes we call it predictor. Okay. Similarly, we have a second thing, the future. Future is the testing data. Basically, we divided data in two parts. So we have a part is called testing data, in which we have 20% or 30% data. Using that data, we will test the model. Like we will check our model is working perfectly or not, how much accuracy this is providing to you. This is the use of testing data. Okay. Here the process, how the machine learning works. Basically, you can see we have training data. Similarly, you can see here, we have training data. We train the machine learning algorithm with this training data, or we can say we use this data to a model as an input, and we will build a machine learning algorithm, right? After that, we build a machine learning algorithm. After that, we have some new input data that we can call, we have testing data. We feed this testing data to the algorithm. Okay, and then algorithm will predict the results. Okay, if result is correct, then we can say it is the successful model. If result is incorrect, then we can say it is not a correct result. We need to train the model again. So basically, hum ek result se decide nahi karte. We need to test it over some data. And according to that data, we have expected output. We have output and we get the expected output. Then we differentiate, we calculate the accuracy, error or accuracy using the expected result or actual result. And then we can define our model is providing 90% accurate result, 80% accurate result, or 95% accurate results. Okay. So I think now you got what the procedure we will follow in the machine learning. Okay, these are the simple steps you need to follow in the machine learning. You need to have some data, then you need to divide the data in two parts. One is the training, another one is the testing. Using those data, you will learn, train the algorithm, and then using the testing data, you need to test the algorithm. Okay. And there are the different types of machine learning. One is the supervised, another one is unsupervised, and third one is reinforced learning. Basically, I have divided in the broad category. There would be some semi-supervised or some other types also, but broadly we can say we have three types of machine learning. Shupriyans is asking, ma'am, please explain testing data with the help of example. Shupriyans, basically when we will implement the ML algorithm, that time you will see the example. Okay. So I'm just coming one by one. Okay. Fourth thing is supervised learning. In supervised learning, we have some data set, and in the data set, what we have some features and then the label accordingly. Like I have provided a basket of fruits to you, and initially, like you do not know about the fruits, what is this? I have provided a basket of 100 fruits to you. In this basket, there are four category of fruits, and these fruits have label over it, like a apple have written label over the apple, like apple, then over the banana, it is written banana, and then over the pear, it is written the pear. So similarly, we have data set, we have some fruits and fruits with labeled, okay? So basically, when you want to implement the machine learning algorithm, what you will do, you need to extract the features. Like fruits ke aapko features nikalne. Basically, how you will do the feature extraction, you will get some feature. There are lots of ways to extract the features. You will get the features like its height, color, shape, size, orientation, kind of things. All the properties you can view with the image. You need to write down. Like aapko apple ke sare properties likhne hai. And then at the end, आपको एक label class लिखनी है. Label class में आप क्या लिखेंगे? Apple. Okay? Like you need to write the different features, and the last thing should be label. And in the label, we write the label of the fruit. Okay? And there would be the some features. This is the color. I'm writing the color C, height, H, orientation, O, something like that. आपको इस तरह से बहुत सारे features लिखने होते हैं. ये सारी चीजें जो हैं वो features हैं. Okay? And this is the output. Okay? This is the simple output. So basically, we have data. In the data, we have some features and some labels, right? Now come to the next slide. What we will do basically, using this data, we simply train the model, train the algorithm. Using this data, we train the algorithm or model, and then we get some output. How? This is the training data. ये आपका training data होगा, जिससे आप model को train करोगे. Now you have model with you, and you will got some new sample. You will feed the new sample, and then you predict what it is. So it will give you a label. Like it is an apple, it is a banana, it is an orange, something like that. Okay? This is the type of classification. यहाँ पे मैंने आपको एक simple supervised का एक general example बताया. Supervised में different type of supervised machine learning होता है. First thing I can say it is a classification. Supervised learning, we have a type of learning is a classification. In the classification, what we have finite set of labels, like aapke basket mein kitni type ke unique fruits hai. That you can say finite set of labels. Like if you have four unique fruits in your basket, then you can say you have four classes, four unique labels. Okay, so basically the here we can have finite set of labels and the features. So what we will do, we will train the model, and then if we will give a new input to test for the model, then it will provide you output out of these unique category. Like aapne agar char categories se train karaya hai, to aap usko koi bhi input denge, wo un char mein se koi ek output aapko dega. इन सब के हम प्रैक्टिकल एग्जांपल करेंगे. मैं थोड़ा कंसेप्ट से समझाने की ट्राई कर रही हूँ आपको. अब मैंने यहाँ पे एक एग्जांपल लिया है जिसमें मैं आपको ये बता रही हूँ कि फीचर्स क्या होते हैं एंड देन क्लासेस क्या होती है. आपको कई सारी टर्म्स नई इंट्रोड्यूस हुई हैं अभी। सो बेसिकली एक टर्म आपकी है जो सबसे ज्यादा काम आती है, वो है फीचर्स। ओके, फीचर्स क्या होते हैं एंड देन आउटपुट क्लास क्या होती है। ठीक है, ओके, फीचर्स एंड देन आउटपुट। ठीक है, ओ इज ए आउटपुट। हियर इन दिस एग्जाम्पल यू कैन सी वी हैव टू फीचर्स, वन इज इनकम, आई एम राइटिंग विद द हेल्प ऑफ आई इज इनकम, एंड अनदर थिंग इज सेविंग। ओके, एंड देन वी हैव सम आउटपुट क्लास। सो हियर यू कैन सी वी हैव इनकम फीचर एंड सेविंग फीचर। अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट वी विल क्लासीफाई डेटा इंटू टू क्लासेस, वन इज हाई रिस्क क्लास एंड अनदर वन इज लो रिस्क क्लास। सो बेसिकली लाइक हम इस एक डेटा पॉइंट को देखते हैं, इस डेटा पॉइंट में हम लोग क्या कर रहे हैं, इस डेटा पॉइंट में वी कैन से इनकम, इट हैव इनकम 10,000 एंड सेविंग इट हैव लाइक 10,000। सो इट विल फॉल अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ हाई रिस्क। सिमिलरली द रेड कलर वन, रेड पॉइंट्स आर द इनकम, दिस इज द इनकम, लाइक इट हैव 20,000 इनकम बट इट हैव सेविंग 15,000 काइंड ऑफ। सिमिलरली हियर द पर्सन हैव लेस इनकम बट मोर सेविंग, देन इट इज ऑल्सो फॉल अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ हाई रिस्क। सो दीज देर आर द टू आउटपुट क्लासेस। इन आउटपुट वॉट यू विल गेट आउटपुट, ईदर लो रिस्क और हाई रिस्क, एंड इनकम एंड सेविंग आर द फीचर्स। ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ इनकम एंड सेविंग यू विल कैटेगराइज इन टू द टू कैटेगरीज। सो दिस इज द सिंपल एग्जाम्पल ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन, एंड हियर आई थिंक यू गॉट इट, वॉट इज द फीचर एंड वॉट इज द आउटपुट क्लास और लेबल। समटाइम वी कॉल इट क्लास, समटाइम वी कॉल इट लेबल, समटाइम वी कॉल इट आउटपुट। ऑल थ्री टर्म्स आर इक्वल। ओके, सो दिस इज द सिंपल एग्जाम्पल ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन। आई गॉट सम क्वेश्चन। इज देर एनी प्रॉब्लम इन माई वॉइस? Can you guys confirm me? Nibha is telling me audio problem. No, Nibha, other ones are telling me no, ma'am. So please check your earphones. I think I have fixed it. Okay? So these are the simply the features and the output classes. Okay, now come to the next. I'm erasing the drawing. Some other applications of classification are face recognition, character recognition, spam detection, medical diagnosis, biometric recognition. In all these examples, you can say we have certain classes. Basically, आपके पास कुछ features होंगे and then आपके पास कुछ classes होंगे. Like आप face recognition की बात करते हैं. So first, what you will do, you will train the model with the help of some images and then you are also providing the tag. You can see the example of Facebook face recognition. How Facebook is doing the face recognition? Basically, what the people are doing, they have your image and they have your profile name. So according to that, they extract the feature from your image and they give it to the label is your profile name. So whenever you are uploading a new picture of your friends, it will automatically suggest you this person maybe एक्स वाई जेड या दिस पर्सन में भी जो भी नेम होता है उसका आपको नेम दिख जाता है। सो बेसिकली उनको कैसे पता चलता है, दे हैव इमेजेस विद देम, दे एक्सट्रैक्ट द फेस फीचर, एक्सट्रैक्टेड द फेस फीचर एंड दे हैव द लेबल एंड दे ट्रेन देयर मॉडल, दे इंक्रीमेंटली दे ट्रेनिंग देयर मॉडल। ओके, सो बेसिकली दे ट्रेनिंग देयर मॉडल विद द हेल्प ऑफ सम फीचर एंड द सर्टेन क्लासेस। ओके, similarly the face recognition or the spam detection, medical diagnosis and biometric recognition. Just a second, plug in the model. So these are the simple examples of classification. Now come to the next. The another type of supervised learning that we study is the regression. There are lots of algorithms falls under the category of supervised learning. We are limited to course content, so mostly we will do the regression and classification. Okay, so in the regression, what it is, basically we have some features and the output is basically a numerical value. You can say it is a real value. It provide you prediction in the form of mathematical value. In the last example, you have checked, like in that we have certain class as an output. But in this case, we have certain numerical value as an output. This is the difference between the classification and regression. Just a second. Okay. So in the regression, what is going on? Okay. Right, in the regression we will predict a numerical value. So when we will use this algorithm, simply when we need to predict a numerical value, like I have taken an example here, we have some feature and some prediction value. Like you can see here, I have car mileage as a feature and the prediction is car price. So simply in the car price, what you will get, you will get some mathematical value, you will get some numerical value. Okay, so we will be using this x as a feature and y as a output. So this will follow the equation of line. Simply, what is the equation of line? Y is equal to mx plus c. You know, I think most of you already know, y is equal to mx plus c. Here we have x and y. What is the x and y? X is our features. Features are independent of independent feature. Like x aapke paas kya hai? Features hai. Feature independent hota hai. Feature kisi pe bhi dependent nahi karta. So x is a, we can say x is a independent variable. Right? And on the basis of the feature, we are going to predict some value that is called the y. That is called the price. So price, we can say, is a dependent variable, right? So we have some independent variable, we have some dependent variable, and using the independent variable and certain constants, we will get prediction of dependent variable, right? So what we will be doing here, like this is the point, okay? This is the point. And in this point, we have some mileage, this. And we have some price, like we have mileage of 50 or we have price of 5 lakhs. Simple. And don't think about the data. Main roughly koi bhi data le rahi hu. Okay, so like we have mileage of 50 and we have price is 5 lakhs. So this is the data point and this is the actual data we know. But what our model is predict, our model is predicting when we have a mileage of 50, then price would be the like 6 lakh. Here you can 6L or here you can 5L. Okay, so this difference basically in between the difference is called the error. Like this difference is error basically, right? So we need to calculate this error, and this our blue line is, we can say, is a best fit line. That line is provided by the regression. It's difficult to write with the pen, okay, but I'm just trying to write something. So this line is, we can call, best fit line. And we predict this line with the help of algorithm. We have data input, like these cross points are the data input, and these are our predictions. So how we can say this is the best fit line? Like agar aapka model is line ke bajaye yahan koi line banata hai ya fir niche koi line banata hai, then it is not a बेस्ट फिट, बिकॉज एरर आपकी मिनिमम होनी चाहिए। अगर आप ये लाइन बनाते हो, इस तरह की कोई लाइन बनाते हो, तो आपका यहाँ पे जो पॉइंट होगा उसके एरर बहुत ज्यादा हो गई, राइट? यहाँ पे जो पॉइंट होगा उसकी एरर भी ज्यादा हो गई। सो सिंपली हमको ऐसी लाइन बनानी है जो मिनिमम एरर दे। परम इज आस्किंग, डू इट हैव ए टू बी ए स्ट्रेट लाइंस इक्वेशन मैम, एंड इफ इट इज ए कर्व द एरर विल बी लेसर। इन द केस ऑफ, मैं अगर जब लीनियर रिग्रेशन की बात करती हूँ, देन इट वुड ऑलवेज बी ए लाइन, एंड कर्व भी होता है, कर्व नॉन लीनियर में होता है। बेसिकली रिग्रेशन, डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ रिग्रेशन होता है। फर्स्ट टाइप इज लीनियर, दैट वी आर ड्रॉइंग हियर द सिंपल लाइन, एंड देन द नॉन लीनियर वी हैव सम कर्व्स। ओके, लाइक आपकी इक्वेशन अगर सर्कल के जैसी इक्वेशन बनती, देन इट वुड बी ऑब्वियसली इन द कर्व। ओके, इक्वेशन हम एल्गोरिथम से बिल्ड करते हैं। बेसिकली हमें डब्ल्यू एंड डब्ल्यू नॉट की वैल्यू ऐसी लेनी है, एक्स हमारे पास है, डब्ल्यू एंड डब्ल्यू नॉट की वैल्यूज ऐसे लेनी है कि हम वाई में वाई की वैल्यू बहुत अच्छी प्रिडिक्ट करें नियर टू रिजल्ट। तो हमें एडजस्ट क्या करना है, डब्ल्यू एंड डब्ल्यू नॉट इन द एल्गोरिथम। ओके, और ज्यादा क्लियर हो जाएगा जब थोड़ा सा अपन इम्प्लीमेंटेशन करेंगे। दिस इज द सिंपल लीनियर रिग्रेशन आई कैन से। ओके, सम एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ रिग्रेशन, लाइक व्हेन वी वांट टू प्रिडिक्ट सम न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यू, देन वी विल यूज द रिग्रेशन एल्गोरिथम्स। लाइक इफ यू वांट टू प्रिडिक्ट द स्टॉक वैल्यू, प्रिडिक्ट द वैल्यू ऑफ ए स्टॉक, और यू वांट टू प्रिडिक्ट द नेविगेशन लाइक कार और प्लेन नेविगेशन, एंगल ऑफ द स्टीयरिंग व्हील, ऑल दीज थिंग्स वेयर यू विल गेट ए न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यू इन द आउटपुट, and simply the temporal trends like weather over the time, all these will give you the output in a numerical value, right? So in these cases we implement the regression. It depends on your problem, like आपके पास कैसी problem है, कैसा data set है, उसके according आप define करते हो कि आपको linear regression use करना है, multilinear regression use करना है, आपको classification use करना है, that you need to choose. Okay? रैंकिंग इज ऑल्सो एग्जाम्पल ऑफ रिग्रेशन, दैट इज प्रोवाइडिंग सम न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यू, फ्लाइट सर्च, री रैंकिंग, ऑल दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल। सो सिंपल टू टाइप्स ऑफ सुपरवाइज लर्निंग वी हैव डन टिल नाउ। नाउ कम टू द अनसुपरवाइज लर्निंग, आई टेल इट व्हेन वी विल कवर द टॉपिक। बेसिकली इन द अनसुपरवाइज लर्निंग वॉट वी हैव सम डेटा लाइक दिस। Like we are taking our previous example, fruits example. In that, in the case of supervised learning, I have provided to you a basket of fruits with the labels. But this time, what I will do, I will provide a basket of fruits to you without any label. Like मैंने आपको एक basket fill करके दे दी, उसमें किसी में भी कोई label नहीं लिखा, and you do not know anything about the fruits. आपको पहले से नहीं पता कि ये कौन सा fruit है, क्या है. You are a new learner. You are a new baby. You do not know about the name of the fruits, like it is an apple or it is a banana or it is an orange, mango, something like that. So what you will do, basically you will see the fruits and then you will categorize based on the features. So you will make some groups or you will make some clusters on the basis of the properties, right? जब हमें पता ही नहीं है क्या चीज है, तो हम लोग क्या करते हैं, हम लोग उसको देखते हैं, ट्राई करते हैं उसके पैटर्न को रिकॉग्नाइज करने की, कि इसमें कौन सी चीजें एक कैटेगरी में जा सकते हैं, कौन सी दूसरी कैटेगरी में जा सकती है, राइट? तो हम लोग उसके डेटा को देख के उसको कैटेगराइज करते हैं, उसके ग्रुप्स बनाते हैं, क्लस्टर्स बनाते हैं। दैट इज कॉल्ड द अनसुपरवाइज लर्निंग, एंड क्लस्टरिंग इज एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अनसुपरवाइज लर्निंग। In that we have given a data, that is the examples, but no labels. In this case, We provide some features to the algorithm, but we are not providing any output label. Okay, guys, now got it? What is the difference between supervised and unsupervised? बाकी चीजें हम बाद में देखेंगे और हम जब इम्प्लीमेंट करेंगे तो थोड़ा और अच्छे से समझ आ जाएगा. अभी मैं आपको थोड़ा सा डीप लर्निंग बता देती हूँ. डीप लर्निंग क्या होता है एंड हाउ इट इज द डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द मशीन लर्निंग. ओके, और रिलेटेड टू द मशीन लर्निंग. सो सिंपली डीप लर्निंग इज अ पर्टिकुलर टाइप ऑफ मशीन लर्निंग दैट इज द इंस्पायर्ड बाय द फंक्शनैलिटी ऑफ आवर ब्रेन सेल्स कॉल्ड न्यूरॉन्स व्हिच लीड टू द कंसेप्ट ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल न्यूरल नेटवर्क. बेसिकली गाइस, डीप लर्निंग में क्या करते हैं, वी आर फॉलोइंग द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ आवर ब्रेन सेल. वी हैव न्यूरल नेटवर्क एंड वी हैव न्यूरॉन्स इन आवर ब्रेन एंड आवर न्यूरल सिस्टम टेक्स द डिसीजंस अकॉर्डिंग टू द सिचुएशन. सिमिलरली वी वॉन्ट टू बिल्ड इन अ मशीन, वी वॉन्ट टू बिल्ड अ न्यूरल नेटवर्क, आर्टिफिशियल न्यूरल नेटवर्क इन द मशीन एंड दैट वुड टेक सम डिसीजंस, दैट वुड लर्न सम components and take the decisions according to the situation. Okay, so basically what we need to do here, we need to make an artificial neural network. Okay, neural network ka ek example main aage dikhati hu. Basically what is the difference between the deep learning and machine learning? Now we can differentiate it. Basically, in the machine learning, as I told you, example of fruits, you need to extract the features manually. Okay? आपको manually features निकालने होंगे. आपको एक-एक feature manually, like कि आपके पास images हैं, तो आपको features को data format में बनाना है. आपको कुछ Excel बनानी है, CSV बनानी है. कुछ एक format में आपको features लिखने पड़ेंगे. You cannot fit the images directly. Okay, so basically you need to extract all the features from the data set. And in the deep learning, what we will do, we will directly feed our images to the neural network and it will automatically extract the features. Basically, you can say deep learning skips the manual step of extracting features. Here the feature extraction is automated. So like हम लोग एक एग्जाम्पल लेते हैं. यू हैव सम इमेजेस ऑफ डॉग एंड यू हैव सम इमेजेस ऑफ कैट एंड नाउ यू जस्ट वॉन्ट टू डिफरेंशिएट, लाइक यू वॉन्ट टू ट्रेन ए मॉडल दैट विल डिफरेंशिएट इट इज ए कैट और इधर इट इज ए डॉग. सो वॉट यू विल डू इन द सिंपल मशीन लर्निंग, यू नीड टू एक्सट्रैक्ट ऑल द फीचर्स ऑफ द कैट इमेजेस एंड ऑल द फीचर्स ऑफ डॉग इमेजेस एंड देन यू विल प्रोवाइड सम label, right? But in the deep learning, what you will do, you will simply feed the images and labels, it will automatically extract the features. Now what is the benefit? You can say, ma'am, basically in the, like aap manually kisi cheez ke feature extract karte ho, like aapko cat ke features extract karne hain, to aap log kya karoge, आपको जितने लाइक आप फीचर एक्सट्रैक्ट कर रहे हो तो आपका देखने का पर्सपेक्टिव जो भी होगा, आप कैसे कैट को रिकॉग्नाइज करते हो, आप उसके हाइट देखते हो, कलर देखते हो, टेल देखते हो, शेप देखते हो, आइज देखते हो, जितनी चीजें आपको लगता है आप देख के रिकॉग्नाइज करते हो, इज इट पॉसिबल टू अदर पर्सन इज ऑल्सो सीइंग द सेम डिटेल्स? नो, बिकॉज देर आर द लॉट्स ऑफ पर्सपेक्टिव्स. हर एक पर्सन का पर्सपेक्टिव अलग होता है रिकॉग्नाइज करने का चीज. So you need to write all the possible features so that everyone can recognize. Okay, so basically in the machine learning, we need to extract all possible features. Okay, and in the deep learning, what we will do, we will feed some images and it will automatically extract the features. So the step of manual feature extraction is eliminated here. Okay, guys? And you can say deep learning is a subpart of machine learning. So जब भी हम deep learning पढ़ते हैं तो आप लोग कुछ machine learning के algorithms भी पढ़ते हो. That is the traditional algorithms you should know. Okay? And it is not like Somebody have written a question. Just a minute. Deep learning is based on the platform recognition. No, pattern recognition. No, Aarti, it is not a pattern recognition. Basically, it is an algorithm in that we recognize the things. It can be anything. Like whatever the task in which you are making the machine intelligent, you want to make a machine intelligent, you can do with the help of deep learning. Supriyansi is asking a question. Deep learning is a software or it is a programming language? I can say it is not a software and not a programming language. It is a field in which we have lots of algorithms, or we can build our own algorithms also. So it is a field, it is a sub part of machine learning in which we implement the things. We implement the algorithms. And there are lots of predefined algorithms available. And the way in which we implement the deep learning is called the neural network. And the programming language we can use either the Python, MATLAB, and some other language also. But basically, most of the people are preferring the Python, because I can say it is the easiest language on the earth. Okay. Like here, I just want to tell you the features. Basically, features kya hote hain, labels kya hote hain. Maine bahut saare example leke try kiya aapko explain karne ka. Like here, I have a square. And at a glance, जब भी आपने देखा, देखते ही आप लोगों के दिमाग में क्या है? It is a square. How can you recognize? Like the features that you must know, like sides should be equal, closed, perpendicular, right? These four property at least you should know. Then only you can classify it. It is a square. So what I need to tell here, I just want to tell you, like here we have some object. So we need to extract as much features that is the minimum requirement to recognize that object. And in the machine learning, that features we need to extract by manually by using the manual steps. Okay. But in the deep learning, it will automatically extract, neural network will automatically extract the features. Okay. Here I have taken an example of deep learning. Like in the deep learning, how neural network works. This is a simple example I have shown you. Like roughly, मैंने आपको दिखाया यहाँ पे internal layers की मैं बात नहीं कर रही. Is this a cat or dog? आप एक इमेज लेते हैं. उस इमेज को आप डायरेक्टली फीड कर सकते हैं. यहाँ पे आपको डेटा फॉर्मेट नहीं चाहिए. Okay? You can directly feed the image, and then image will be feeded to the algorithm input. There are lots of layers in the neural network. First layer is called input layer. Then we have some internal hidden layers, and then we have one output layer. So we will feed the image to the input layer, and then it will pass to the other layers, and finally it will predict the output. So basically, in the internal layers, what is happening? There are we need to implement some functions that is called the activation functions. And the information passing from one layer to another layer through the neurons. Okay, so basically this is the simple algorithm. I just want to show you only internal iske details mein hum nahi jayenge. And applications of AI and deep learning ML you already know. I don't need to explain it. Like bahut sari applications hoti hain jo aap day to day life mein use karte ho, right? Like first one is Google Maps, and then the auto friend tagging suggestion, alt tag generation. What is this? Basically generating the description of a particular image. Okay. And then the different apps you are using, ad recommendation, virtual personal assistants like speech recognition, speech to text conversion, natural language processing, and text to speech conversion. And the beautiful application of deep learning is self-driving car. First time the Tesla developed the AI-driven NVIDIA's hardware and they use the neural network to the build a self-driving car. And you can see over there, goeduhub.com, there is the review section. You can see some of my students already tried hands-on many of the projects that you can see here. Like one of them is self-driving car and the object recognition. All these many projects in the last to last year trainings, my students already developed. So you can see their feedback. Okay. And Netflix recommendation and some other applications like fraud detection, Google Translate, dynamic pricing, search engines, MRI, scene classification, all these are the example of AI. Okay. And one more thing, like when you need to choose the deep learning and when you need to choose the machine learning. It depends on the scenario, it depends on the data set you have and the things do you have, processing power do you have. Like if you have lots of data, huge amount of data, then you should opt the deep learning. Here you can see the graph, like when you have less data, then your older machine learning algorithm will provide you good performance. But like when the amount of data is increasing, our older algorithm provides the constant performance and the deep learning algorithm provides the good performance. So it is up to you. You need to, like whenever you are working in an organization, you should choose the things, you should decide the things. You will get some data and you will get some problem, like using this data, you need to solve this problem. Then what you will do, you will try the different algorithm to implement over that data. First you analyze the data and you will examine like which algorithm I should apply for this data, so that it will provide you the good answers, okay? Good predictions, right? So simply first parameter you can consider is amount of data. Second is hardware dependency. Like for deep learning, you need the good hardware. For the student purpose, it is okay. You can work over your same computer. You can implement ML, you can implement deep learning. But when you are working in an organization, you are working in some company, then resources have matter. Like it keeps matter. Basically, you need to consider good resources for the deep learning. Feature engineering, how to feature extraction happens in the deep learning. Like we will feed an image of a person, it will extract the patterns of local contrast and then the features of the person, and then it will save the features and the labels. Okay, so basically, I think you should know now what is the deep learning and what is the machine learning. When should I choose the deep learning? When should I choose the machine learning? And what is the artificial intelligence and different applications of AI, ML, and deep learning? Okay, and how these fields are connected to each other. Okay, guys. So this is all about the theoretical part of AI, ML, and deep learning. Now I'm coming to your questions. Just wait, guys. Mrinmoy is asking, ma'am, what is the difference between face detection and recognition? These are the totally different algorithm. Mrinmoy, what is the your name? Sorry, I'm not. I think I'm not getting properly. Okay. Mrinmoy. Okay. So basically, in this, in the face detection, you are detecting the face area only. Like in case हम लोग जब आप लोग कैमरा ऑन करते हो, आप कोई इमेज क्लिक करते हो किसी भी फ्रेंड की या घर पे. So basically, what it will detect? It will detect a part of body. It is detecting only the face part. So this is the face detection, in which what it will do, we have a model, and in that model, what we will do, we will feed the image of different faces. Okay? हम लोग उसको train कराते हैं face के image से and non face images से, और उसको हम ये बताते हैं model को कि जब भी face की image आए तो वो उस पे एक बॉक्स बना दे, ओके, एंड इन द फेस रिकग्निशन, फॉर द फेस रिकग्निशन वी शुड फेस डिटेक्ट, वी शुड डू द फेस डिटेक्शन. सबसे पहले हमें फेस का एरिया डिटेक्ट करना है, उसके बाद हमें उस एरिया में जो फीचर्स हैं वो हमारे मॉडल में फीड करके ट्रेन कराना है. बेसिकली हमें क्या करना है, फेस के फीचर्स से ट्रेन कराना है. लाइक हम आपकी इमेज, आपका फेस रिकग्निशन करना चाहते हैं, तो मुझे एटलीस्ट आपकी 50 इमेजेस चाहिए फेस की, जिसमें मैं क्या करूँगी उस मॉडल को डिफरेंट डिफरेंट एंगल से, या जैसे भी आपके पास डेटा सेट है उससे आप मशीन को ट्रेन कराएंगे. ओके, हम फीचर्स, फीचर्स मीन्स आपकी आईज, शेप, कलर, नोज, नोज कलर, नो सॉरी नोज शेप, फेस कलर, आईज शेप, इस तरह से हर पर्सन के अलग अलग फीचर्स होते हैं. सो आप एक इमेज फीड कराते हो तो आपके फीचर्स वो रीड करता है, और आपके फीचर्स के साथ वो लेबल क्या देता है, आपका नाम. सिमिलरली दूसरे पर्सन का फेस आप देंगे तो उसका फेस और फेस के फीचर्स एंड देन द लेबल, राइट. निखिल इज आस्किंग अ क्वेश्चन, मैम यू आर नॉट ए रोबोट थिंग इन द डीप लर्निंग, राइट. आई एम नॉट गेटिंग निखिल योर क्वेश्चन, जस्ट रिपीट इट. ओके निखिल, जस्ट एलोबरेट योर क्वेश्चन, व्हाट यू वांट. क्लिक ऑन द इमेजेस थिंग. लाइक यू लाइक आप ये बात कर रहे हैं, आई थिंक कंफर्म दैट यू आर ए बॉट और ए रोबोट. ओके ओके, दिस इज द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ डीप लर्निंग, राइट. जब आप क्या करते हो, नॉट ए रोबोट. हाँ आई गॉट इट योर क्वेश्चन. लाइक आप किसी किसी साइट पे जब रजिस्ट्रेशन या कुछ भी काम करते हो तो आपको कुछ सर्टेन पैटर्न्स मैच करने होते हैं, ठीक है. तो अब क्या होता है कि नॉर्मल जो पर्सन क्या होता है, जब कोई भी वेबसाइट पे एक ट्रैफिक आता है, एक ह्यूमन बीइंग होते हैं, कुछ प्रोग्राम्स भी होते हैं, है ना, कुछ बोट्स भी होते हैं. तो प्रोग्राम्स हैं, वो प्रोग्राम्स होंगे तो प्रोग्राम, एआई का कोई प्रोग्राम बनाकर वहां पे रजिस्ट्रेशन, मतलब कोई एक इंटेलिजेंट प्रोग्राम बना दिया और उसने छोड़ दिया कि अलग अलग वेबसाइट जिन पे डेटा रजिस्ट्रेशन करा रहे हैं वहां जाके आप उनके वेबसाइट से कुछ इंटरनल चीजें निकाल के लाओ, उनके डेटाबेस में से कुछ, या इस तरह से. सो वो प्रोग्राम जाएगा, प्रोग्राम रजिस्टर करेगा, बट जब उसको डिफरेंट डिफरेंट पैटर्न्स मिलेंगे तो वो उसको रिकग्नाइज नहीं कर पाएगा, बिकॉज प्रोग्राम को हम एक पर्टिकुलर लेवल तक ट्रेन करा सकते हैं. एक पैटर्न के लिए ट्रेन कराया, लेकिन जो अपन गूगल पे पैटर्न्स पूछते हैं वो अलग अलग पैटर्न्स पूछते हैं. सो उसमें हमारा प्रोग्राम फेल हो जाएगा एंड ह्यूमन बीइंग उसको मैच कर देगा, राइट. सो ये चीज है. अब जैसे ऐसी चीजें हम बना सकते हैं, हम एक प्रोग्राम बना सकते हैं जिसमें फेस रिकग्निशन करा रहे हैं हम. अब फेस रिकग्निशन में हम लोग क्या करा रहे हैं, हम लोग लिमिटेड फेसेस का डेटा रिकग्नाइज करा सकते हैं, जैसे फेसबुक वाले करते हैं. वो आपके प्रोफाइल पे आपके फ्रेंड्स का डेटा ही रिकग्नाइज कराते हैं, किसी अननोन का नहीं कराएंगे, राइट. सो दिस इज द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ डीप लर्निंग निखिल. ओके so this is the simple theoretical part of the machine learning. Now come to our contained part. Okay, you need to read this module. QR code is also we can use with the neural network, we can read with the neural network. This is also part of deep learning. Okay, Supriyanji? Like this module, you need to read supervised machine learning algorithm. And this is written by some student, Suyesh. Is there any Suyesh present in this class? Or it is a student of another class? Let me check. I think he is a student of another class. He has also written the good answer of this. Like here, basic of supervised learning. And then you can read this one also. This is also a good example. He has given what is the supervised learning, classification, and the regression. Kanika is written. Thank you, ma'am. I like the way you explain, ma'am. Thank you so much, Kanika. Okay, guys. So today I thought you got the basic concepts, and I'll like implementation part. It won't possible to complete in a single day, like same day. So we will do the tomorrow. And one thing we will do today is we will cover one remaining part of Python, because we need to complete the हेलो गाइस, हेलो, आई थिंक नाउ ऑडिबल। ओके 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 ओके, थैंक यू। सो क्लास इज बेसिकली, यू कैन से इट इज ए स्ट्रक्चर, एंड देन आर ऑब्जेक्ट इज दैट कैन एक्सेस ईच एंड एवरी एलिमेंट ऑफ द क्लास। वी कैन से सम एट्रीब्यूट्स, वी कैन से सम वेरिएबल्स और सम फंक्शंस। ओके, सो बेसिकली हियर हाउ टू राइट द क्लासेस, आई एम जस्ट कमिंग टू द एग्जाम्पल ओनली। थ्योरी पार्ट यू कैन रीड इट बाई योर सेल्फ, इट इज वेरी सिंपल। ओके, so here I have created a class called employee, and then the simply a variable where one there may be an indentation problem. You can shift this to the right side, where one is equal to first name, where two is equal to last name, where three is equal to email, right? And then what we are doing here, we are defining a function inside a class. So how to define a function inside a class in the Python? Simply write a name, like write def keyword, then function, and the parameter self should be present there. At least one parameter called the self should be present there, right? So simply we are creating a function called fun, and inside the function we have written two print statements. One is simple name and second one is email. And how to access the variables like self dot var one, var two and var three. Okay, then what we are doing here, this is the simple body of the class from here to here. Okay, then we are creating some objects like e1 and e2. And with the help of those objects, what we are doing, we are accessing the values. Okay, so we have two objects, one is E1 and another one is E2. So separate two memory locations are provided, one for the E1 and another one for the E2. And now accessing the objects with the class attribute like E1 dot var xyz, E1 dot var two small xyz, E1 dot var three xyz at the rate gmail.com, and simply for the E2. So for E1 we have XYZ and for E2 we have ABC, right? Now what we want to do here, just we want to print E2 dot var. So if you are printing E2 dot var 1, then it will print the ABC, right? And then E1 dot fun, you are calling the function E1 function fun with the help of object E1. And what E1 has? E1 has XYZ variables. So it will print here. We are calling this function, and this function will print all three values of the all three values is stored inside the E1 object. Basically, two object hai aapke paas, ek E1 hai, ek E2 hai. E1 mein teen variable hai, var 1, var 2, var 3, and E2 ke andar var 1, var 2, var 3 hai. Ab aapko kya karna hai? E1 ke jo values hai, unme XYZ karke hai, and E2 mein ABC hai. अब आप किससे कॉल कर रहे हो फंक्शन को, कौन से वेरिएबल को आप प्रिंट कर रहे हो, उस तरह से आप यहाँ पे कॉल कर सकते हो। सो सिंपली कैसे क्लास कंस्ट्रक्ट करते हैं, कैसे फंक्शन कंस्ट्रक्ट करते हैं, कैसे ऑब्जेक्ट्स बनाते हैं, एंड कैसे फंक्शन को कॉल करते हैं, ये सिंपल चीजें इसमें दिखाई है। Use of self. Self is you can say it is a kind of syntax, by default parameter. If we have a method which takes no argument, then we still have to have one argument at least. It is, I can say it is a syntax of Python. Okay, and then next is come to this, like Python constructor. Python constructor, how to write the Python constructors? Basically underscore underscore init, and then underscore underscore, and then the parameter. This is the syntax of the constructor. आप लोग कोई भी constructor नहीं बनाते हैं तो default constructor इसमें create हो जाता है। ओके व्हाट इज द मिस स्पेल्ड मैम इट इज अंडरस्कोर अंडरस्कोर इन इट और नॉट नो नो इट इज आई एन टी आई इन टी इट इज नॉट मिस स्पेल्ड इट इज द करेक्ट वन हियर आई थिंक आई हैव गिवन यू द रॉन्ग इट इज नॉट आई एन टी आई दिस वन इज करेक्ट सॉरी 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 इन आई एन आई टी INIT is a correct one. There may be this one is wrong. Right, you are right. Okay, we will edit it. Don't worry. Thank you. Okay, and this is the simple constructor. Like if you are creating a default constructor means you are not passing any argument, simply you are passing a self parameter. Okay. And when you are creating a constructor with the parameters, then you can see here self and then comma and then the variable name. Okay. So these are the ways how to create a constructor. And how to call these things given below. You can read it by yourself. And deleting in the Python class, simple del and then the class name. Yes, this one is also corrected by some student. We will check it. Okay. So basically, this is the concept of class and objects. Like now you know the syntax of class and objects. Okay, so this is all about for today's class. Okay, guys, and if you have any query, you can ask me now. Okay, so thank you all and please like revise the concepts. Okay, so tomorrow we will do the implementation of regression. Okay, okay guys, bye bye.